welcome to the greatest place to have a wedding. Yeah. Well, you all come a long way. Our flight was 6 hours, and you come from Europe, you come from England, you come from Scotland, of course, Ireland. Australia, Singapore. Now what?
Hong Kong.
England.
Hong Kong.
And we come from New Zealand originally. We brought Sonia over. She was very angry. You're 16 years old. But she's done very well. I'd like to thank
Eamon and Ola.
Eamon and Ola. Their family has treated us very well, and we love them, part of our family. Yeah, and part of their family. Yeah. Of course, Sonia is our number two daughter, and our sister couldn't come, and a lot of people would have loved to come, and they send their best wishes to everyone. Sonia, we're very, very proud of Sonia. Yeah. She's achieved a lot in her lifetime that I never would attempt. My wife, Kay, we look up to her, and especially this day, she's fulfilled her dreams. She got a little girl, Ashy. Yay! Ashy, you want to say hello?
Say hello.
Say hello.
Hello.
Her husband, Simon. Simon, he's such a competitive guy. He likes golf, soccer, and a little bit of rugby.
A little bit, yeah.
But we come from New Zealand, we're number one.
Chokers.
Looks like you're not the only competitive.
I'm trying to teach him to play bowls. I give him a set of bowls, and he always wants to beat me.
And he has done.
Yeah. He gets me drunk. He takes me to some little place. Long grass, and he beats me. Yeah. But Sonia and Simon, they met at Paddington. Paddington Bar.
Sleep in.
Prince of Perry Bar. Yeah, but we're just that, over the moon they got married. And thank you, Simon and Sonia. And I'd like you to charge your glass and toast Simon and Sonia, and best of the future, Simon and Sonia.
Sonny.
Well done.
Cheers.
Yeah, well done.
The other one was the other night when she was organizing something. We were told we were going to the dick bar. Now, I thought I was being sent to an all-male gay bar, but it was actually the death bar downstairs. In all seriousness, I'm up here first, and I'm going to take the opportunity to say I have never seen such a stunningly beautiful bride in all my life. She is gorgeous, I don't say. And I have to say, as well as being a beautiful lady, there is no doubt Sonia is a beautiful person. She has proved, from the time we've known her, she's proved she's a fantastic mother. The time she gives to Aisling, despite the pressures of career and all the rest, are just fantastic. And certainly, Paul and myself are so proud that we have this beautiful lady coming into our family. And equally, any of you who know them and have known them with the family, you know that this commitment they've made today, it's for life. Moving on to Simon, my son. I said this at Colin's wedding, I'll say it again. I consider my sons my friends. I think and I hope they consider the same. It's a friendship than a father-son relationship. And I love it to have it that way. I can go for a pint with them, we can have a sing-song and have all the crack. I think that's very important. Coming through, Simon was a good kid. He did the right things. He studied, taking after his mother. He was very competitive, taking after his father. He actually excelled. He was very good at soccer, golf, very competitive. I gather there's a big question mark at this stage over the Aussie handicap. Gusso would have something to say about that. Sorry, Angus would have something to say about that. Gusso was Gusso when he left Europe, but he became Angus when he came to Australia. The one downside in Simon was, when you told him off, doors got slammed, the kiddie tantrum things, you know? And then a moody for maybe 18 hours afterwards before he relaxed, Orla would have to go up and ease him out of his bedroom. I just hope he's grown out of that scene. Simon was always the prankster, and I think this is a classic. When he was 3, we were on holidays in France. We always stopped off in Paris. We were coming through the gardens in Versailles, walking down steps, and at the end, on both sides, there was statues of ladies with nothing on top. Okay, boobies with nothing covered. And I'm 20 yards with Orla, walking ahead of the two of them. And he's 3, Colin is 5, and he's turning around to Colin going, at 3 years old. The other thing used to be when we went camping, Colin, the older brother, was always the responsible one. So we put to bed 9:30. We camped every year. And we'd be sitting outside, most of the time with Dennis. And next thing, you'd hear talking inside. Colin trying to be concerned, the other fella, the little devil, trying to do something. And then inevitably, at about 11:30, the zip would start to open. And this little impish head would stick out as if to say, I'm still awake. And you had to let them come out and play for a while. And funnily enough, Aisling does the exact same thing when she wakes up. But there's other sides to Simon as well. And one, in fairness, he's very, I have to get through this. He's very caring and compassionate. And it was like 3 years ago, my father died. And Simon was in Australia and couldn't get home. So he decided he'd write a letter to my father that we should put in the coffin before he was buried. And I have to say, the letter he wrote was the greatest tribute I have ever read from one human being to another. Colin got it on the email, and at the time, Colin was the eldest grandson, and he was to write a tribute and present at the church, at the funeral. And when we got the email, he printed down 3 times. Myself, Orla, and Colin went to 3 separate bedrooms and probably cried solid for at least 15 minutes. And Colin then decided, right, that's it. That is such a tribute. I'm not going to write anything. He put all the grandchildren's names at the end of it and he read it out in the church. And there wasn't a dry eye in the house. It was just fantastic. And that's Simon. Something that has always stuck with me. A good few years ago now, I had a bad car accident. I wasn't injured, but I was very upset with the outcome of the thing. And I was very upset when I got home, the lads were there. Simon at the time was 17. And I remember I was going up the stairs at one stage. He was at the top of the stairs. And he just grabbed me and hugged me hard, like he meant it. Looked me in the eye and said, Dad, it'll be all right. And that's Simon. Attributes that Simon will bring to the marriage. I wrote these down because I thought long and hard about them, and I hope I can read my own writing. He's loving, caring, compassionate. He'll be, and I hope you're listening, he'll be very loyal. He'll have great integrity both in his work and in the marriage. He's very honest, great patience. Since Aisling was born, he's very responsible, and only since then. He's very, very hardworking, and I think, as we've all seen, he's proved himself to be a fantastic father. And I know I'm supposed to... yeah, it was like a holiday, a Hollywood wedding, wasn't it, today? I can't stop without saying something about Aisling. Anybody here who's a parent knows that, really, when you have a child, you understand what life is about. But anybody who has a grandchild will know that then you really understand what life is about, because your children have had children. And Aisling has brought such joy and pleasure to myself and Orla. It is just fantastic. It's tough, us being in Ireland and them being in Australia, but we do get the opportunity with Skype, and we play games, we laugh, she does her Irish dancing, she gives us bits of banana that probably destroys the laptop, and we always get cut off early when she hugs either myself or Orla onto the laptop. But we, at least we can see her growing up, and we're fairly regular visitors, and she's made such a difference to us. She's our first grandchild. Well, I better say, Colin and his gorgeous wife Orla have our second grandchild next in December. Just again, everyone who knows Aisling, you know that she is a beautiful child. She's a fantastic temperament, very friendly, full of fun, and really, it has to be down to the two fantastic parents.
Better place to talk about a beautiful friend than in beautiful Bali. Both are warm and fun, both have the spirit of adventure, and both have been involved in the consumption of copious amounts of alcohol. She's our little pint-sized New Zealander who packs a punch. In fact, many of you don't know that's why Sonny moved from New Zealand. One country couldn't contain her. To the Gold Coast, then to London, then Sydney, she was unleashed on the world. No one can deny that Sonny is full of energy and passion. Everything she does 100%. She's the life and soul of the party and can turn any occasion into a fun and fabulous event, which I just been talking about for weeks. And today is no exception. But underneath the bubbly, cheeky and charismatic exterior, there's the other Sonny. The wonderful mother to Aisling, the generous and caring friend who stands by you through thick and thin, the friend who you always would wish for, and we all feel so very lucky to call her one of ours. From relationships to careers to children, Sonny has been there to provide her loving support and advice to all of the things life has thrown at us through the good times and bad. And then there is Sonny, the super efficient, organised and practical. Only she could organise to get 50 friends and family to Bali from all corners of the world. 46. She never does anything in halves, and that's why I was so thrilled that she found her other half in Simon to share her life with. Simon, with all the lists and checklists that Sonny makes, you obviously had a lot of positives to go in the pro column to outweigh a very glaring negative in the con column, your daggy old grey tracksuit pants. Sonny could see past the fashion faux pas and has found a keeper. But Simon, since you are both MasterChef fans, here are our top tips. happy, bright future together. Firstly, the TV remote control is communal property. You have to learn to share.
I'm just good with it. Quicker.
If there is ever a disagreement, you are always wrong. Sonny's favourite flowers are lilies. Congratulations to Sonny and Simon. We are all so thrilled that you two soulmates found each other in this big world. And thank you for sharing this special day with us. And may you live long and happy lives together. To Sonny and Simon.
Beautiful bride I've ever seen in my life. Just feel so proud, just feel so blessed. Sonny always said to me that she's I'm the luckiest person she's ever met. And today, she's not what she means. It's just crazy.
We got that from you, Tomo!
So to be here in this beautiful paradise with all the people that we love, with our family, with all of our best friends. From the bottom of our hearts, we just can't thank you guys enough for making the effort to come here. That's from the both of us. We're just completely humbled and amazed that everybody came. I mean, when we decided we were going to get married in Bali, we hoped that people would come, but we literally didn't expect anybody to come. And, as Ian said, it's from the four corners of the globe that people have come, and it's just... When I was standing there and I was turning around, and I could just literally feel the love in the room and the well wishes in everybody's eyes. And it just, as I say, my heart was just ready to burst. And then when I seen Aisling coming down, I don't know how I actually managed to hold on to it. I had a little bit of a shake, then I saw Yanni going, and I went, oh, no, here we go. The boys are watching, I'm going down. And then when Sonny came down, I was just... Yeah, I think an explosive came out of my mouth. It wasn't planned. But she was just angelic, I think is the word. So I just want to mention the bridesmaids, these ridiculously beautiful women who just stunning today. As a few people have said, Sonny, I can't believe they actually picked those girls to be bridesmaids. For Sonny, and she just really appreciates it, and from the hands and all the work that you guys have put in. You guys were her rock. That's the only reason she got through to the house, because of you poor people, and you just mean the world to her. You're her girl, so. And to Yanni, I just want to make special mention to Yanni, the work that Yanni put in. I'm sure you guys all saw the Save the Date wedding and all the invoices that went out. And Yanni is just an incredibly gifted and artistic woman, and she gave all her time.
My absolute pleasure.
You're just such a good friend. To my groomsman. You got me here today, just about. I'll be in a headlock going up the hill, but they managed to get me here. Gusso, we actually got Gusso into a pair of shoes.
I'm shocked.
Sean, we had to get him to change out of his football boots. He had his suit on and a pair of football boots. And I was 50-50 as to whether he was actually serious. Because it's just been amazing to have you guys here, my best friends. It just makes me so proud, and I just feel completely blessed to have you guys as friends.
To my brother, Cully, who's just been, Cully's been my rock, he's just been, he's amazing, And to have your own brother as your best mate, it's just quite a special feeling, As you say, you don't get to choose your family, so when your brother ends up being,
being your man, it's just been special.
I probably shouldn't thank him too much because he's probably hanging with the door for those 2 weeks. But anyway.
To Ian and Kay, I just can't say enough about you guys. You just made me feel so welcome since I've come into your family, since I came up and saw you guys in the Gold Coast.
you've just been amazing, and almost like a second set of parents to me. It's just been so nice. Yeah, you couldn't be better. Ian gave me a set of his bowls, and I didn't prompt you out and squashed them out on the bowls.
You know, as they say, I'm quite competitive.
So he was telling me to try the game with it.
But no, look, honestly, guys, I can't thank you enough. I feel really blessed to be a part of your family, and it's just been great. Thank you. To my own parents,
Look, I think from my dad's speech, you can tell how close we are as a family. They are literally our best nights when we're at home, we're all about drinking. When we were younger, we had our moments, you know, we were a bit cheeky and bold and all that, but it's just, it has literally progressed into a relationship where we are just really good mates, and we're just so proud of our folks.
Both of us,
myself and Colleen, they've just given us such a good template. As parents, and just the love that they have for each other, and they've been married for, I'm just going to say donkey's years, because I don't know. But you can just see the love that they have for each other, you know, and that's always what I aspire to, and to be able to have that now myself, it's a special feeling, you know. So, yeah, look, just thank you so much. You guys have just been wonderful, and yeah, big love, you know, we love you. And I guess last but by no means least to my beautiful bride here, who is sitting resplendent in her dress this evening. I don't know where that came from, it just kind of floated in from somewhere. Sonny has just put so much work into today. It has just been a work in progress for so many months, and she has just been amazing throughout the whole thing. I mean, everything you see here today, down to the candles, the little cards on the table, she's just worked everything out to the nth detail. And I was just thinking about it, and her whole drive for doing it is really for you guys. That's why she wanted to do it, to make sure that everyone who came here, and the effort that you guys made to be here, she wanted it to be perfect for you guys, not even so much for herself. And I think that just says so much about Sonny. She just cares about her friends and just, you know, puts them ahead of herself. She's just, yeah, she's an inspiration, to be honest. Just had such an impact on my life. I mean, I came to Australia about 6 years ago, and I was a bit of a lost soul, to be honest. I didn't quite know where I was going, what I wanted to do, what direction my life was going to take. And as corny as it sounds, when I met Sonny, everything just kind of fell into place. Life just made sense, you know. She just taught me so much. She taught me what love was. As bad as that sounds, it was. Yeah, she just filled my heart, and she just has made me want to be a better person and a better father. And I don't know if I've quite done that, but I do try. But I just can't say enough about Sonny. I just feel like the luckiest man in the world to stand here beside this beautiful, amazing lady. I feel like my heart is on my breast, you know. We were so happy together, and then we have Ashling, and things have actually got even better, and we're just so close as a family. We've got so much love for Ashley. Sonny's just the most amazing mother you can imagine. And hopefully we'll have a few more. Watch this first. Maybe one. But anyway, yeah, look, I'll wrap it up, because I could ramble on about Sonny all night, if you let me. Just to say, everyone that's here, from myself and Sonny, from the bottom of our hearts, we cannot thank you enough for making the effort to be here. You're just our special friends. I'll be handing out the love and the hugs later, so just join up. Thanks, guys. Have a great night. Thank you.
Right, let's lower the tone slightly now. So, if I could say a few words, I'd
be a better public speaker.
He used to ring me and tell me all about her, how cool she was, and what a great time they had together. And it was very clear from the first day that he was mad about her and he felt that this was the one for him.
It was hard to develop a relationship with Sonny at the start, though, because most of the conversations were had when one or either party was standing outside the pub and the other screaming into the phone. I actually don't think we needed the phone for the conversations we had in the first 6 months we got to know each other. It was ridiculous. But eventually, Sonny made the long trip to Ireland, and we all hit it off instantly. Her sense of fun, humour, and generous nature made her very easy to love, and she had a lot to contend with as she was examined and interrogated by everybody just to make sure that she was on the level as Simon said she was. And she passed out with flying colours, obviously. Since then, she's made the trip a couple more times, and we have always loved having them to Dublin, although my liver and digestive system might not agree with that. We nearly put them back in the plane. I don't need a drink anymore. Of course, there's been another person as well that brought a lot of pleasure and melted a lot of hearts, and that's little Miss Ashling. Didn't she look absolutely fantastic today? She's such a little treasure. She has everybody running around her, especially her grandmother. I think her grandmother actually makes her run, so she can just chase her a bit more. It's great. So anyway, I want to wrap this up. Guys, I'm absolutely delighted for both of you today. I'm very proud to have such a great brother. He really is my best mate. And, you know, we've always been there for each other through thick and thicker, I think. And it's brilliant now to have a wonderful sister-in-law. You know, it's hard at times having your best mate living on the other side of the world. But when you come here today and you see the love that they have and the family that they have together, it just makes them all more easy. And I'd like to wish them their long health and happiness in their marriage. So, if you could all stand, please, and raise your glasses to the bride and groom. Simon.
Cheers.
Day from Robin and Jeff Cook. And lots of hugs and kisses and stuff there. Here's a couple from your schoolmates. I remember the first time I met Sonia at Burnside High School. I was a 14-year-old in our form class, and I knew straight away that this girl and I were going to be friends and get up to some fun and some mischief. And sure, I wasn't disappointed. We had lots of laughs and met loads of interesting people along the way. But when she moved to Australia, I could tell that was the country where she was most happy, and you're still happy there, Sonia. Wish you happiness and joy in your marriage, and that you will savour all the adventures along the way together. With great love comes great meaning of what life is really about. And you now have each other to share with. Lots of love from Catherine, Richard, Josh and Abby from New Zealand. Dear Sonia and Simon, congratulations on your marriage today. May it bring you many happy months, the years to follow. Enjoy your day from Sonia Sparks in Christchurch, New Zealand. Okay, dearest Sonia and Simon, I'm really sorry I can't be with you today to celebrate this fantastic occasion. Many congratulations on getting hitched. I remember when it all started, the summer of love, shall we call it, 2006-2007. I'm so glad I was there to witness the start of your time together, and I'm thrilled that you now have Ashling and are getting married. I have so many happy memories of my time shared with you two in Oz, and I'm looking forward to seeing you again in the near future. I hope today is truly wonderful, sunny and memorable. Don't forget the slip-slap-slap. With love and cherishing you both, I'm with you in spirit for sure, and that's from James.
Oh,
James. From Michelle, Flawn, Christian, Corey, Jamie, Kalani, and Indiana, congratulations, sister. We hope you don't make the same mistake as I did and have five kids.
No chance.
You never have enough money for everything. We hope you enjoy your special day and wish you both the very, very best that life brings. We're really sorry that we couldn't make it to your wedding. but we will be thinking of you all on your big day. Lots of love from all of us. Hugs and kisses. Are the children gone to bed? I've one that starts out with greetings from the shithole in the sand. I trust you're having a fantastic day. Sorry I can't be there to celebrate with you guys. I wish yous both a wonderful and happy future together, and we'll hopefully see yous next time when we're all back in Ireland. I'd say the video message from the boys at home is good crack. We would love to take a part in all that, but enjoy the rest of your day. I know you don't need to tell you guys how to party. I'm sure it'll be totally blanco. So lots of love and best wishes from Seth.
Thank you.